Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I wanted to talk about the Egyptian numeration system. And this is a simple grouping system. And in our Hindu-Arabic system, we have place values. So a 5 can have a different value depending on where it is. But in the Egyptian system, the symbols have the same value no matter where they are. And they're grouped together, which is why it's called a simple grouping. So we have what we call a stroke, a heel bone, a coiled rope, a lotus flower, a pointed finger, a tadpole, and a scribe. And sometimes you see things, may see things a little differently. And so those symbols have changed for different people over the years. So you can see this is the same set of numerals. The hieroglyphs, though, could be a little different. Sometimes instead of a scribe, I've heard astonished man. I don't know really what the official was originally, but what I want you to be able to do is use the value of those symbols to write them into the into our system, Hindu Arabic. This one, though, says give the value of each numeral and then give the sum of the numerals using Egyptian hieroglyphs. So first I want to figure out what the value of each of these is. Well, a lotus flower is, I'll pull it down a little bit so you can see that. A lotus flower is 1,000. So we have three of those, so that makes 3,000. And we have two coiled ropes, that's 200. And four heel bones, that's 40. And then four strokes, that's 4. So the value of this number is 3,244. And the second one, there's two pointed fingers. And pointed fingers are 10,000, so that's actually 20,000. One lotus flower, 1,000. Two coiled ropes, 200. Three heel bones, that's 30. And then seven strokes, that's 7. And you would just add all that up to get your number. And so we have 21,237 is the total of that number. What does that sum look like in hieroglyphs? Well, in hieroglyphs, we would add up all the strokes, and there's 11. So we wouldn't put 11 strokes because after 10 strokes, we can make a heel bone. So we'd say, okay, we have one stroke. And then we're carrying over a heel bone. So I want to remember that I've actually added a heel bone on here now. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, plus that other heel bone. So I have 8 heel bones. Maybe yours are going to look nicer than mine. That's as close as I'm coming to a heel bone. So then I have 4 coiled ropes. Look like and signs, maybe. And then I have 4 lotus flowers. This is the biggest pain to draw, I think. You gotta trust me that I'm drawing lotus flowers here. And then 2 pointed fingers. And I think in the next frame, it asks you to say, what is that in Hindu Arabic? Well, that is 2 pointed fingers is 20,000. 4 lotus flowers is 4,000. 4 scroll or coiled ropes is 400. 8 heel bones is 80. And then 1 stroke. So if you add all that together, you get 24,481 would be the sum in Hindu Arabic. And so indeed on the next page, it says, find the difference of the numbers given above, which one should be subtracted from to avoid a negative number. And so of course we want to subtract from the greater number, which was the second number, the 2 pointed fingers, lotus flower, this one right here, that was 21,000 compared to 3,244. So I'm not going to do the subtraction out longwise, but you can get the idea that if you want to subtract four strokes from this, you would just cancel out four strokes. But if you wanted to subtract four heel bones, you'd have to borrow from a coiled rope and make 10 more heel bones and then subtract, right? From here, sorry, you'd borrow from here because you're subtracting from that greater number. But it says, give the answer of the sum and the difference as Hindu Arabic numbers. And that sum I just did. So the sum in Hindu Arabic was 24,481. And then we saw earlier that the greater number was 21,237. And the smaller one was 3,244. So this is just the notes in the problem. If I ask you to write it out, you're going to want to do that. But you could find it this way and then take it back and change it into a Hindu Arabic, from Hindu Arabic into Egyptian if you wanted. So that's the Egyptian grouping method and how to go back and forth between those. Also, the Egyptians had a really cool method for multiplication. So I'm going to show you that one next, on the next video. Have a great day.